I was gonna get up, and I did, and then I got back into bed. If you saw my video yesterday, you'll notice I was moaning about muscle soreness, which has eased up a lot today, so I feel much better today. I can walk without looking like John Wayne. Hello. Hey. My eyes. What are you doing? So I haven't walked Ivy in a couple of days. Not that she hasn't had a walk. Bryony's been walking her because I've been quite busy training. I think probably one of the nicest pleasures in life is owning a dog. Like, they are just the best animals ever. Everyone's like, there's so much commitment. They're worth every bit of commitment. They really are. For anyone that follows the vlog quite closely, I fixed the pedal on the butcher's bike and changed the saddle. Made it the actual right height for me. Didn't feel like I was riding a child's bike. So today I wanted to talk about disc brakes and hydraulic and mechanical disc brakes. The differences that I found doing a year on mechanical and doing about the last 7-8 months on hydraulics. But before I do that, daily vlog, I need to clean my bike, yeah? This is my last season's bike and I use mechanical. So as you can see, an actual cable runs through. So unlike having fluid in the actual outer housing itself, it's got an actual cable like you would with gears or rim brakes. I'm not a mechanic. I didn't design the brakes, but what I want to do today is tell you about the advantages I found on hydraulic compared to running mechanical brake. So let's start with the mechanical. What advantages and disadvantages did I find using mechanical disc brakes while bikepacking and ultra distance racing? So firstly, I found they required more maintenance. Yes, more maintenance, because the cable would stretch over time. The pads probably weren't as good, but I just found that I was actually having to adjust them a lot more over the season than I would if they were hydraulic. Also, the next thing I found is they were very easy to maintain. So just say I was on a long trip, I always found a lot of security, knowing that if I had any issues, it was literally just a cable change away. So that was always a nice feeling for me. But when I was actually doing big long races and big long descents, I found because it was harder to get the wheels to slow down, it was making my hands hurt over time. So I was getting some really bad hand pain and wrist pain when I was doing these massive descents. Like, for example, TCR number 7. And I was coming down this big, after CP1, I was coming down this big descent. And by the time I got to the bottom, I'd been riding all day. My hands hurt because it was just this pressure of having to do this all the time. And I'm someone that does a lot of like weight training and stuff like this, so having a strong grip is very important to me. And if I'm struggling, then I can imagine other people would be as well. So to overview it, they were required more maintenance, they were harder to use, but they gave me a sense of security knowing that I could pretty much fix them anywhere in the world with just a cable. The biggest thing I noticed though was power-wise. Like I said, they're harder to use. So when you're using hydraulics, you literally just have to tap it and then you've got this really extreme power going into the wheels. But with the cables, you really have to make it work. And it just made it quite difficult over long, long races. Like, you could get away with it day in and day out, like if you were just doing short rides. But if you're riding 15, 16 hours a day, it would catch up with you. And this really got under my skin, unfortunately. So that's kind of the reason why I came away from them. So these are hydraulic brakes and these use a fluid that run down the actual tube. So when you pull it, the fluid compresses and then pushes onto the pads at the back and boom, it grabs the rotor and stops it. The hydraulics. So after I got hydraulics put on, the first thing I noticed was the power's just, you know, unbelievably better than cable. It's just so much easier to brake, and it just takes so much pressure off your hands. So when you're doing long days with big descents and things like that, you've not got this crunching hand pain after a day or two. The next thing was the less maintenance. So as the pads wear down, they seem to self-adjust, and basically it means that you can just put them on your bike, set them up, and then you can pretty much leave them. Providing you look after the pads and keep the discs nice and clean, then they will literally just look after themselves. And this is really, really nice on my side of things, that I don't have to keep coming back, keep adjusting them while I'm riding, thinking, oh, is it time to do the brakes, all this. It was just taken away from me. So it made it really simple and easy to use. I guess the drawback with hydraulic, that if you were bikepacking or ultra distance racing and you had an issue, like when you were flying, one of your cables got snagged and all the fluid came out, then you've got issues, because it's a little bit more difficult to bleed a brake on the road, and you'd have to carry a bleed kit as well, than it is just to change a cable. So they have their disadvantages and advantages, but to summarize it though, realistically, less maintenance, better power. You just have to look after your bike and make sure that you're not going to cause yourself any problems by splitting hoses, and make sure you pack your bike well, and they will just look after themselves. Hydraulics are a lot easier than they come across. You could carry a bleed kit if you're really worried. You'd have to learn how to bleed it, and then you could bleed it on the side of the road. I wouldn't really want to be the person to have to do that, but in all the time I've been using the hydraulics, not just this year but years before, I've never had to re-bleed anything. It just seems to be put together and just seems to work. I actually question why I came away from it. I think it was just so I could fix everything on my bike myself without having to go to a mechanic. So to be brutally honest, I think my race bikes will never come away from hydraulics now. I've done a year on cable, I tried it, and it wasn't as good as I thought it was gonna be. It just felt like more hassle for less power. But with hydraulic, it was the opposite. It was like more power for less hassle. You just have to make sure that one, they're set up right, and two, that when you are flying or when you leave your bike somewhere, that you're not gonna snag that cable. That's the important thing. I'd highly recommend hydraulics over mechanical from someone that's raced it for a year. So the question I seem to get asked a lot is, yeah, but Robbie, if you were going around the world, mate, wouldn't you take cable over hydraulic? Honestly, it's a lot of bike shops in the world, a lot of my bleed kits. No, I would go hydraulic just to save my hands. I really would. Cable, I think, the days of cable disc brakes, they're dying, I think, in my opinion. But obviously, this is just my opinion. There's people that will go, oh, cable. But I have gone from saying, oh, cable, to being hydraulic. So in my eyes, I will not come away from hydraulic now. Cable is a bit of a dead memory for me now, but it's on my spare bike because I've only got one set of hydraulic brakes and they're on my race bike. So they will just keep on my spare. Please, if you're enjoying these daily vlogs, make sure to subscribe. I really enjoy doing them. So please subscribe. And you're gonna see some fun stuff, like what I'm gonna do with that. Yeah? What am I gonna do with that? I don't know. Malinsky and my Richie. House full of bikes.